service today for Father's Day, and everything you need is on the order of service or in the hymn books when you came in. And so we begin with the words of introduction on the service sheet. Welcome in the name of Christ. God's grace, mercy, and peace be with you.
And also with you.
We come from scattered lives to meet with God. Let us recognise his presence with us. As God's people, we have gathered.
Let us worship him together.
And so we stand to sing our opening hymn, hymn number 172, Father, Lord of all creation, hymn number 172. Together to ask our Father for forgiveness. turning away from you and ignoring your will for our lives. Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
For behaving just as we wish, without thinking of you. Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
For failing you by what we do and think and say. Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
For letting ourselves be drawn away from you by temptations of the world about us. Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
For living as if we were ashamed to belong to your Son. Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
And may the Father of all mercies cleanse us from our sins and restore us in his image. For praise and glory of his name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the collect for Father's Day. Heavenly Father, you entrusted your Son Jesus, the child of Mary, to the care of Joseph, an earthly father. Bless all fathers as they care for their families. Give them strength and wisdom, tenderness and patience. Support them in the work they have to do, protecting those who look to them as we look to you for love and salvation. Through Jesus Christ, our rock and defender. So, in our hymn books, we stand to sing our second hymn. We can do it twice. So we do. Oh. And Sue's going to try and play the right notes. We're going to do it twice. So, hymn number 606.
Not necessarily the right notes, it's in the right order. We'll meet at the end.
Our God is a great big God, and he holds us in his hands.
New Testament reading. We are God's children. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure.
A larger print version than the one left here. Good morning. The gospel reading is taken from St. Luke chapter 2, Jesus in the Temple. Every year the parents of Jesus went to Jerusalem for the festival of the Passover. And when he was 12 years old, they went up as usual for the festival. When the festival was ended and they started to return, the boy Jesus stayed behind in Jerusalem, but his parents did not know it. Assuming that he was in the group of travellers, they went a day's journey. Then they started to look for him among the relatives and friends. When they did not find him, they returned to Jerusalem to search for him. After 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting among the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. And all who heard him were amazed at his understanding and his answers. When his parents saw him, they were astonished. And his mother said to him, "Child, why have you treated us like this? Look, your father and I have been searching for you in great anxiety." He said to them, "Why were you searching for me? Did you not know that I must be in my father's house?" But they did not understand what he said to them. Then he went down with them and came to Nazareth and was obedient to them. His mother treasured all these things in her heart. And Jesus increased in wisdom and in years and in divine and human favor. This is the word of the Lord.
My dad's bigger than your dad.
My dad's as tall as the moon, as strong as the wind, as wide as the sky.
You should see my dad. He's got stars in his fists. He bends rainbows on his knee. When he breathes, clouds move.
He's good as my dad. You can't scare him with the dark. You can't scare him with guns or sticks. He makes bullies say sorry just by staring. Big green monsters fall asleep on his lap. Ghosts start haunting each other.
My dad's been everywhere, but he says he likes the world. Earth people are fun, he says.
My dad knows more than a teacher. He knows everything. He knows what you're thinking, even when you try to trick him by thinking something else.
If you tell a lie, my dad says he can tell by the look on your face.
My dad's the best dad ever. I say I love him a million times a million times a million times a million trillion.
My dad says he loves me a billion trillion times more than that.
My dad likes to love.
My dad made the world.
Thank you for that. Today we celebrate Father's Day.
It's right, we should thank God for our fathers and the examples they set us and for the love that most of us receive from our dads. Each of us have a human dad or had one, even if for some of us we actually never knew them. Some dads are better than others. We may have had good experiences or bad experiences, or probably for most of us a bit of both. I'm speaking as a father to Jonathan and Sophie. I know I've got some things right, I've got some things most definitely wrong, but I've always tried my best to treat them fairly, equally, to show them love, to laugh with them at times, to discipline them. I've always tried to be there for them, whether it's alongside Jonathan in intensive care following his brain surgery, or picking Sophie up at 1 a.m. on a Sunday morning from town after a Saturday night out with her friends, even if I've got to be in church for 7:30. Whatever our experience of dads on earth, we all have a loving Heavenly Father. It's what we heard in our first reading. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God. As Christians, we are God's children. It's what Jesus knew himself. He had Joseph as an earthly father. He had God as a heavenly father. And that's why he stayed behind in Jerusalem, admittedly, accidentally, worrying his earthly parents. Why were you searching for me? Did you not know I'd be in my father's house? As a 12-year-old, Jesus knew God as his father. And God as father is something we heard in the poem a moment ago. God who is as tall as the moon, as strong as a wind, who breathes and the clouds move. God who is not scared by the dark or bullies or big green monsters. God who knows everything, knows what we're thinking. A God who loves us far more than we can ever love him. Each of us here is a child of God. Whatever we face, whatever we do, wherever we go, we have God with us, the creator of the universe. He is also our loving Heavenly Father. So as we celebrate Fathers and Father's Day, let's do so with one eye on God, our Heavenly Father, and give thanks for that relationship too. So we're going to take our hymn books and stand to sing our offertory hymn, hymn number 170. Father, I place into your hands the things I cannot do. Hymn number 170.
To the bidding Father of all, please respond, hear your children's prayer. Sovereign Lord, your Son has revealed you as our Heavenly Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. Father of all,
you have made your church a spiritual family, a household of faith. Through baptism we are reborn as the brothers and sisters of Christ. Deepen our unity and fellowship in him. Father of all,
you sent your son to give his life as a ransom for the whole human family. Give justice, peace, and racial harmony to the world he died to save. Father of all,
you gave your son a share in the life of the family in Nazareth. Help us to value our families, to be thankful for them, and to live sensitively within them. Father of all,
your son drew around him a company of friends. Bring love and joy to those who are alone. Help us all to find in the brothers and sisters of Christ in a loving family. Father of all,
hear your children's prayer. You are the God of the dead as well as of the living. In confidence, we remember those of the household of faith who have gone before us. Bring us with them to the joy of your home in heaven. Father of all,
hear your children's prayer.
Amen.
So on our service sheets, receive the words of the Lord's Prayer in a sung version. I invite you to remain seated as we sing. Some of it might not be completely familiar. Join in when figure it out. As it's Father's Day, we thought we'd give every man in church a bar of chocolate. There is a choice here for you, so you can choose one and have whichever you fancy. to enjoy with coffee after the service or some point later in the day. I know it's difficult to choose. I'm just assuming they're going to come back and I can have one as well. David needs one, he'll need one throwing up to him. Yeah, throw it up. Sunday the 2nd of July, 2:30. Sunday the 2nd of July, 2:30. Sue's choir are doing a concert in the hall. Please do come and join us. Spread the word. The more the merrier. We have a talented bunch of youngsters and it's good to support them and enjoy listening to them playing and singing and doing various things. So please join us on the 2nd of July. So a blessing. The Lord bless us and watch over us. The Lord make his face to shine upon us and be gracious to us. The Lord look kindly on us and give us his peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore.
Amen.
And so we sing our final hymn, hymn number 777, "To God Be the Glory, Great Things He Hath Done."
Thank you.
to walk in God's light, to rejoice in God's love, and to reflect God's glory.